Here with us now to talk about that, one of the nation's leading voting rights activists, Robert Kennedy Jr. Very nice to see you. He's the author of a shocking article, new article in this issue of Rolling Stone magazine, where you talk about whether or not the GOP has a campaign to deter new voters and discard Democratic ballots in terms of determining the next president. What are you finding? Welcome, by the way. What are you finding that's going on the polls?
Well, there's a new rule called, new law, national law, called the Help America, ironically called the Help America Vote Act. It was authored, or at least the kind of sinister parts of it were authored by Jack Abramoff and Bob Ney, Congressman Bob Ney, both of who are now in prison. And it is designed to erect a series of impediments that make it difficult to register to vote, make it difficult then to vote, and then also impede or make it difficult to get your vote counted.
What kind of impediments? I mean, are we talking about pushing the envelope toward illegal, or just, what do you mean?
Oh, well, it's legal because it's the law, but mm-hmm. It makes it, for example, under these new rules, Colorado, this year, the Secretary of State, Colorado, discarded about one out of every five of the registered voters were purged from the rolls. This was the Donna Dett Davidson, who's the former Republican Secretary of State. She then was promoted for this work to head the Election Assistance Commission by the U.S. Election Assistance Commission by President Bush. Her replacement as Secretary of State, Mike Kaufman, the New York Times reported last week, has since purged an additional 37,000 voters from Colorado's rolls. And last week, he purged 6,400 new voters. Now, how do they do this?
Yeah,
one of the methods that they use is called it's a new provision of HABA, which is called the perfect match, tight match. And what it says is that the election officials in the state should compare the information on your registration form to the existing government databases about you, for example, your Social Security and your driver's license. Mm. In two states, it requires two swing states, it requires a perfect match, Iowa and Florida. That means if there's any differences, for example, if I spelled my name Robert F. Kennedy on my license and I put Robert Francis Kennedy Jr. on my voter registration, my vote would then be discarded.
It doesn't count.
It literally doesn't count. Right. And I won't know that it doesn't count. It just won't be.
It just won't register.
Right.
It won't go through.
Exactly.
Okay.
Robert, this sounds like such a familiar story. After the 2000 election, the debacle that was the 2000 election, we made the Help America Vote Act, which was supposed to stop a lot of this. Then in 2004, again, you wrote a famous Rolling Stone piece, was the 2004 election stolen? Why does this keep happening? Why haven't we fixed these problems if we know they've been out there for years?
Well, one of the things is that there are people within the Republican Party, and these included Karl Rove and Alberto Gonzalez, who have manufactured this, ginned up a kind of hysteria that there's actually out there, that there's a lot of voter fraud. We saw a lot of this in the recent Acorn controversy. And that in order to deal with that voter fraud, in other words, people coming in and trying to vote twice, that we have to erect these barriers like licensing, you know, that you have to show photo ID, for example. Many states now require that. New voters have to include in a separate envelope a photo identification, government-issued photo identification. If they don't do that, if they do a mail-in vote and they don't do that, in many states their vote won't be counted. Now, what does that do? Licenses, you know, you assume that everybody has a driver's license, but in fact, many Americans don't. 1 in 10 Americans don't have a driver's license, and mainly these are elderly people, senior citizens, they're young people, they're urban dwellers, in other words, they're Democratic voters. 1 in 5 blacks of voting age do not have a driver's license. So if you make a driver's license requirement, you're automatically excluding one out of every five black voters. I will say this about Acorn, because I think it's important for people to understand this, that what Acorn was doing was not voter fraud. There was registration fraud committed against Acorn. But as a result of Acorn's work, nobody is going to go in and vote twice. Mickey Mouse is not going to show up at the polls and vote. Okay, the person who was registered 17 times, it's not illegal to register 17 times. It doesn't mean you can vote 17 times. You only vote once. John McCain said in the recent debate that this is a threat.
What are you saying, though? Acorn is completely free and clear of any wrongdoing here?
Well, Acorn, you know, actually what Acorn did was good because Acorn flagged the vote, the votes that it considered shaky. And Acorn is not allowed legally to throw those votes away. Even if somebody registers as Mickey Mouse, Acorn can't take that and say this is ridiculous and throw it away. They legally have to hand them in. And what Acorn did is the ones that look shady, they handed them in and they said, we think these look shady. And then the Republicans took them and they said, oh, look, this is voter fraud.
All right. Hold on. Hold the phone.
Wait a minute. On Acorn, I mean, clearly Acorn was doing something. You
know, here's what Acorn did. Acorn hired 8,000 people, okay, and then told those people, we're going to pay you for every registration you bring in. So a lot of those people, you know, did not have high levels of integrity. And they went out, and instead of doing the hard work of registering voters, they copied the phone book. No. Let me tell you why this is not a problem. They copied the phone book. They copied names out of the phone book. They wrote Mickey Mouse. They wrote Tony Roma. They registered the same guy 17 times.
So they get paid.
So they were ripping off Acorn, but those people who were registered are not going to go and vote twice.
But that's
the guy who's registered 17 times is not going to show up at the poll and vote 17 times. The guy in the phone book whose name was taken out of the phone book and written down, he's not going to go in and vote because he doesn't even know he's registered unless he already registered.
And it just reminds me of the honesty. It sounds exactly like the loan officers who basically could make more money by giving people more money. It's the same thing when you have economic incentives.
Except we all got hurt by that.
I know.
In this case, nobody gets hurt except for Acorn, right? I mean, here's...
Are you buying this?
Listen to this.
I know you guys are friends.
Between 2002... Well, you tell me what I'm saying wrong.
Well, no,
between 2002 and 2006, there were only 24 cases of voter fraud in this country that were convicted or addressed by courts out of 178 million voters. So this is not a problem. In fact, David Iglesias, who was the prosecutor for the state of New Mexico, was ordered by Alberto Gonzalez to prosecute voter fraud cases, mainly Acorn cases. He was given 200 of the best cases. He couldn't find a single case that was worthy of prosecution. There's not a single case in Indiana. Not a single case has ever been found in New Mexico of actual voter fraud, of somebody coming in and saying, I'm going to vote twice, I'm going to vote for a dead person, or whatever.
I understand where you're coming from. Mickey Mouse is not going to vote, but I think Donald Duck might vote.
Donald Duck will?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I think so.
Robert Kennedy Jr., thank you very much. Taking it rapid fire this morning, we appreciate your coming in to the show this morning.
Thanks for having
Yeah, you look good. Spent a lot of money on that
suit. I'm going to take off my tie now.
Yeah.